It had one upper tooth and one lower tooth. So in other words, the teeth have fused with one another, forming quite an arch. In the porcupine fishes and the blowfish, the puffer fish, they have two upper and two lower. So those fishes are called, the whole family is called diodontidae, meaning two teeth. What else can we say? Oh, the fins of a fish. Many fish use their pectoral fins to swim. The pectoral fin is here off to the side. That's pectoral fin, right there. And then you have the pelvic fins down here. Those are the pelvics. And then you have the anal fin. The anal fin is just behind the anus. The anus would be right there. And the anal fin is behind it. And of course, the tail fin is called caudal fin. And sometimes it can have extensions from it. In that coronet fish they showed on the film, there's an extension right from the middle that goes back. And then the dorsal fin can be spinous in the front. These are spines here. And then it can be spineless in the back. Well, this fin that's back here. So you might look at those fins. The pelvic fins can be on the throat or all the way back. Should I open this one up and see what we can find? Now these fish have been here since yesterday. They're not quite as fresh as they were when they first came in. I'm going to take the pectoral fin right off. And remember, the kidney is up against the dorsal body wall. Here we see the liver. That's really hepatopancreas here. And up above that, there's going to be a gas bladder. The gas bladder often collapses because it's attached to the body wall and you usually cut it on the way in. We could trim that just a bit. Parrotfish aren't very good eating. These other fish you'll dissect could be eaten. The heart sits in the throat. Remember, we spoke of the heart being in the throat here. Yeah. Well, large scales. Now some of these fish will have cecae. The parrotfish, being a coral feeder, yeah, look at that, huh? Sacular. Yeah, I don't. No, I don't know about those sacular structures. That's not a parasite, though. Yeah. No, I don't know what those. No, I can't say what that is. I should have looked in the parrotfish before. It's quite a large liver. Let's see if we get, this is the gonad here, up here. I thought that was liver at first. There's the spleen, right there. The red structure is spleen. And the bladder there. I almost think it's better if we each start our own fish, and then I'll open the barracuda, and we'll have all of them. We can look at them more carefully. The barracuda has large teeth. Very large canine teeth. We'll open the barracuda up also. Let's see if we can do it right now. barracuda was lacking one of the pelvic fins. Yeah, the barracuda has a very clean peritoneal cavity. We noticed that yesterday.
Yeah.
Now there's the stomach, and the stomach is empty. At least it's not full. Let's open the stomach. Open the stomach on your fish to see what the fish was eating. If these were freshly caught, of course, the food would all be in very visible. This fish ate 2 days ago, so it hasn't had a meal for a while.
Half a fish again.
But that gives you an idea of what a barracuda is eating. Huh? Now, sometimes you find a hook at the other end. So that stomach, that fish has been dissolving in there. That's the liver right there. Oh, here's a gonad. Barracuda has a long, that's probably testis. And then the gas bladder is this long bladder here. Now, to find the kidney, you have to go above the gas bladder. So if you just sort of do like that, and there's the kidney showing up. Now, the kidney of a fish can be at the front of the back or all along. This barracuda seems to have the kidney all along here. And the kidney is a blood-forming organ as well as a urinary organ. And here we have the pericardial sac opened up. Is that showing here? Yeah. That's the heart. And when you look at the heart, there's one part of the heart that appears white, and that's because of the very thick muscular wall, and that's called the bulbous arteriosus. And coming into the bulbous from the heart would be the ventricle, and coming into the ventricle is the atrium, and behind the atrium is the sinus venosus, this chain. It's very hard to see the sinus venosus because it's a very flimsy thing. And the atrium is also a rather flimsy thing surrounding the ventricle. And that's ventricle and bulbous, the only thing you can see clearly here. The best way to see this is to float the thing in water. If you're dissecting underwater, the organs float out. It's a very good way to dissect. Now, let's see, why don't we look into the jaws here. Look at the gill arches.
Sinus venosus.
Without being bitten, if we can. The gill arches are very slender in the barracuda, aren't they? There should be 4 gill arches. And here you see the gill filaments. The red things are the filaments. And then the gill rakers are in the front. The barracuda doesn't have gill rakers that are even discernible. So why is that? Well, the barracuda eats such big things, it doesn't have to worry what's going to escape through the gills. It just takes it right into the stomach. So there really are no gill rakers here to mount anything. No, I can't feel anything. But the gill filaments, that's for respiration. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 gills is the usual thing. What else should we look at? Oh, that epibranchial organ, or the pseudobranch, that's this here, on the inside of the operculum. And then when you're ready to look for the stones, the ear stones, the red hind has good ear stones, and they'd be right in here. You get to the skull, and you go in on each side of the ventral part of the skull, and that will open up the otic capsule, here and here, of the skull. Yeah, a little behind the eye. So, yeah, all the way back there. We did find them yesterday. We found some nice ear stones. And if you get a big enough one, you can make earrings out of these ear stones and just put a little gold ring through them. And they're nice stones because they're made out of aragonite. Instead of calcium carbonate, it's magnesium carbonate. And they're very durable and make beautiful earrings. Usually you have to have a fairly big fish like that.